Hey, thanks for stopping by. Today I thought that I would give you a tip on driving traffic when customers are inside your store. I'm a vintage seller on Etsy. My store is named Retro Chalet, and I've been dealing in vintage for a very long time, but I even do some handmade. In fact, I made this little necklace, and I was noticing that mainly in my shop, the vintage was selling, but the handmade, art supplies, crafts, and other items weren't, even though I put really good tags and I seemed to be doing everything right. So I started thinking about how could I drive people that are already in my shop to other areas of my shop. And then I really kind of thought about it, and it was really simple. And it was just something that I wasn't doing, or maybe I was just too lazy to do. So let me tell you all about it, and hopefully you're doing it already. And if you're not, you should be. So let's take, for instance, my glove molds. They're my number one selling item. So I actually started with them because I figured customers are already looking them up as I've networked them all over the web. But my crafts, not so much. I even offered these little DIY kits for these cute little pouches. Nothing. Then it dawned on me, why not just do hyperlinks in my item descriptions? So I started with the glove mold. In the description, I describe the glove mold, blah, blah, blah. But after, I thanked customers for looking and told them what was new in my Etsy store. Basically, I tried to put links to sections. Don't do it to items. Your items will expire every 4 months or sell out. You don't want to do that. You want to do it to the actual sections of your store. So for instance, look at my new Instagram guide in this section of my shop. And that stays hyperlinked forever. Anyway, I was wondering, well, how can I tell if this is working? Then all of a sudden, I started getting duplicate sales. Two glove molds in a shopping cart with a handmade art item. Voila, it was actually working. And to prove that, I went into my traffic stats. 39% of my visits were driven from within Etsy or within my own store. Now, it's hard to tell just what of that percentage that I was helping. But the fact is, I saw the proof in my shopping cart with the sales. If you like this video, follow me on Instagram at For Sale on Etsy, where I feature Etsy sellers. Or you can connect with me on my own channel on Instagram, Retro Chalet.